Oh dear, Linda doesn't feel like getting up this morning. Yes, I didn't pull the cold start out. Okay. I thought I'd pull the cold start out, but clearly I hadn't. So, she should just start right up now. So let's see. Okay, let's get the fuel right. Okay, here we go. Okay, Linda, you got your fuel. Let's go. Okay, well, that answers that. So, yet again, it is me that is the weakest link. Well done, Linda. You finally woke up once I set your alarm. It's funny, before I knew anything about the cold start button, it used to take me quite a while to get Linda started last winter, and then of course I went and got the fuel pump serviced, and it turned out that the biggest issue I had was just the fact that I didn't know how to use the boat. The fuel pump was actually in very good condition. Anyway, shall we go? Just remembered, because the boat is going nowhere. Okie doke. We're gonna have to get the boat out.
Oh yeah, no wonder. That's like really thick plastic.
Okay, we got a knife. Precious.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, man, this stuff is... feels good, thick plastic. More oil black plastic.
Look at the redness of my arm. Ooh, it's cold. And we're back.
Bridge. Ow!
I was filming that boat because we were going slowly and I just got whacked by the bridge. It's a good thing I have no brains because otherwise I'd get brain damage. Yeah, looks like we're gonna have to thread through the eye of a needle.
Thank you! That's great. Yeah, plenty. Thank you very much.
And set the lights. Can't go through the tunnel unless you got the light on. The last time I went through tunnels, I didn't have the fenders, didn't have the tires. So this should be a lot easier to get through the tunnel without crashing, hopefully. If not, I might have to drop the e-boards in. Nosing the boat in, and the tire is keeping it away from the wall, and the back end is sticking out. But this seems to be working quite nicely. Major, just a bit of a scratch there, so pull that off and adjust. A bit of masonry. This is taking all the brunt, and then the boom is just bouncing around. And the main reason is just simply because I think I put too much faith in the tires sort of bouncing me off the wall, and I thought this would be okay. But I need the boat to be on that side, obviously, and this bit here in the middle. So this time I'm gonna aim for the other side and rest the boat on that and slide my way through using the fenders, keeping my... God, it's very fast. This is as slow as it's going, and yet I'm feeling it's too fast. Much nicer. So I'm thinking if I keep it nudged up against that side on the left. How are we doing? Oh, that's close. Oh no, I wasn't even looking at it. There you go. Oh, you mean underneath?
It'll bump you outwards.
Great, thank you for that.
This is the bit where he's talking about. Let's get down the centre of it. Thank you. this bridge coming up as a site of a massive disaster. A boat transporting explosives was coming under this bridge, and for whatever reason, it ignited and blew up the bridge. The bridge was rebuilt exactly as it is. One little quirk is that the tow ropes, or the guide ropes, that were used to... not the guide ropes, the ropes used to pull the boat along by the pony, used to leave grooves in the pillars. So when they re-erected the bridge, they turned the pillars around so that the grooves were on the other side, and they cut fresh new ones in for the pillars. I haven't crashed. I'm just waiting for a tour boat to come racing around the corner. We're in the old clear. This is now gets wider, and there won't be any boats coming. Well, there will be boats coming, but they can pass by with ease. It's just one little bridge. But the bridge has got plenty of sight lines, so we can get through safely. And then we're in Camden. We're in Camden right now. But Camden Locks are coming up next. Gongoos are ahead. Pirate Castle. Linda is waiting patiently. There's another boat coming up the next lock, as you can see in the distance.
So every time I now come into the bridge, I have to really be careful about where I position the boat.
Look at the wind and the trees at the other side of the bridge. So there's a big gap and the wind is now blowing down through that gap, so I have to expect a crosswind. New eco moorings. Aren't even on the tiller anymore. It's now autopilot. It's just running itself.
Good.
Ooh. The roof just shrunk. There is a huge amount of smoke in the tunnel now. And it's quite, it's getting up my nose. It's quite asphyxiating. So we're halfway. We're halfway. See the dock behind me? That's the exit. The entrance we came in. Ahead of us is how we get out. See the fog?
Every now and again the tunnel just shrinks. Headroom.
smoke there.
Traffic jam.
These are eco-mooring sites, which they provide electricity. The idea is that you don't need to use your engine, or you don't need to, you know, you can use electricity. But the only thing is you have to book in advance, and as I didn't really anticipate that I'd be getting this far, I would have booked in advance. 7 days mooring, perfect for Linda. Anyway, not to worry, carry on.
Just do it.
Yep, another lock. Now, after this lock, we don't have anything on Seal Broadway. So, there might be a mooring spot there, but if not, then we're into Victoria Park, and if not, then who knows? But it looks like we might be going in the dark.
Thank you.
Thank you.